राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय
राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम राम जय राम जय जय राम हरि ओम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हरि ओम टू एवरीबॉडी
हरि ओम सभी
Ramdas is hard sometimes. He is hitting you because you are taking the spiritual question lightly. You are going about like butterflies. Devotees. Everybody is here to realize God. We are serious about it. Papa. Then you should follow Ramdas's teaching. If that is not done, what is the good of coming to this ashram? You say, Papa, Papa, Papa. Hang on to his question. He is within you. Concentrate upon him within you. This is what Mataji also was asked to do. She had so much dispassion for the world, her mind did not wander. Don't get stuck up to your personality, he told her. When Ramdas cut her mind off from his personality, the mind at once went inside her. You come here and think of the world. What meditation can you have? You are planning, planning, planning. Some are now here for so many years. Their bodies are here, but their mind is outside. Concentration requires the whole mind to be fixed upon God. How can you concentrate if the mind is outgoing? If not outside, it is attached to this body. Papa, papa, papa. Physically you are sitting, but mentally you are wandering. Mind must be one point, then you will get absorbed in the truth. Your goal is the truth. Truth is within you. You must fulfill the condition. You must be tremendously earnest. Your one concern should be to realize God. That aspiration should be yours through and through. No dilly-dallying, no trifling with the question of God. Otherwise it is a hobby, a thing of passing interest. With many people, it is a hobby. If you are really sincere in your quest, you must not waste a single minute. Two friends meet, they talk about so many other things and waste hours together, which time they could easily have utilized for sadhana. If you had that hunger, you would practice sadhana. Curiosity will not do. You read any number of books like the Bible, the Gita, so and so, so and so. They guide you and show the path, of course. Afterwards, you should lay the book aside. Be engaged always in concentrating and meditating on God and God alone, not allowing the mind to wander about. Devotee, Papa's method is to repeat the name. Papa, repetition for the sake of remembrance. Remembrance is the important thing. Ramdas practiced that and he got what he wanted. He therefore advises others to take to that path. If that is not the suitable way for you, go to others who teach different paths. Ramdas did not want Ramcharan Das to accompany him. He would say, so long as I am with you, I do not want sadhana. Ramdas said, if you depend upon his company for maintaining a pure mind and a blissful experience, then after his body drops, what will you do? So you must get this experience by your own sadhana. And it will then remain with you always. So this is how today Papa talked to us, how to become earnest, you know. We feel our mind, we are also earnest. At the same time, we feel we are not reaching anywhere. There is a subtle frustration in our mind. So when we go through that, again we try to go through and we try so many exercises, experiments upon ourselves. We have to experiment. Because we don't know which path is suitable for our equipment. The moment we hear a speech, we are enthused, inspired. Next moment we want to live up to that. After some time you will see the euphoria gets evaporated. Equipment is not ready, not that you are not inspired. You are unable to hold on to what you have been inspired before. So now that means we must have a sadhana independent. What is that written on your back? Last one. You must have a sadhana which is independent.
Wherever you are, you must be able to tune yourself to God.
So you must have a sadhana which is independent. We don't know what is our line. So only by trial and error we can have. We can gather all these details. But sit quiet and find out by trying. As we keep on doing the trial and error method, mysteriously our own methodology gets evolved. There are so many methods, you know. We will read a few portions from Vinobhaji's, where silence speaks. Exactly, suppose we concentrate upon that, we might be able to identify the factors which are blocking us. While performing a task, the common experience is that the mind has an external focus. However, for inwardness, we need seclusion and meditation. How do we reconcile these two opposites? The moment the mind comes to play, it is going out. It has a tendency to go out only. See for yourself. When you close your eyes, the mind goes out to objects, situations, questions. But here we say inwardness. Inward journey is necessary. So how to reconcile? In going outward, but what is needed is inward. How do they reconcile? What needs to be remembered? So when we get frustrated, no? We want to take the inward journey. Somebody used to come and ask, what is inward journey? Really serious to know what is inward journey. But with a mind which is focused on outward journey, how to know the inward journey? So what is the technique by which the same mind can be made to take to inward journey? Mind is the vehicle. We have no other vehicle. Let us see what he says. What needs to be remembered and imbibed is that as long as the duality like external and internal or outward or inward remains, we have not even really begun. We differentiate something as inner, something as outer. This is very highly subjective. We request everybody to be highly attentive, please. Because he is bringing out our problem, no? Crux of the problem. So long as there is external and internal, outward and inward, he says bluntly that we have not even started the journey. We differentiate something as inner, something as outer. We understand that the inner is Brahman and what is outside is not Brahman. This means we have broken Brahman into two, which is unrealistic. Knowingly we are not breaking, but we have broken. God that exists inside is the same God that exists outside as well. The external God will be recognized with the eye. The inner God will be experienced in the consciousness. The inner God appreciates the beauty of the God that exists outside. Accept it with open eyes, open ears, open mind, then you will attain samadhi effortlessly. I often talk about a pilgrim's mind. God is within us, with us all the time. But we forget that, we push him away and seek him in different holy places, one after another. Similar to this pilgrim's mind is a meditative mind. God is both inside and outside. But we must refuse or fail to see the one in front of us and insist upon seeing the one which is deep within us. This way we move the God that is in front of us and send him inside. In fact, there is no such difference as inner and outer. So long as the duality exists, you will not experience ultimate unity. It's a matter of continuous practice to be able to see and experience God everywhere. As God is both inside and outside, there is no fear within or without. All the fear is in the mind, hence remove or transcend the mind. One cannot get rid of the inner or outer world. We must get rid of the mind. Brahman is both inside and outside. In between them is the mind, which is an illusion. And if you can free yourself from the mind, then the job is done. Transcending the mind is the thing to be achieved. We see different manifestations around us. We see different types of people, different forms of nature. As long as one does not experience God in all these, one cannot achieve self-realization. Learn to see God in everything. In Gita, Lord Krishna says, I am Himalayas among the mountains, Ganga among the rivers. So the practice should be such that we should gradually start seeing God in everything and all activities should be done as worship. Whatever walking you do it as a pilgrimage. Whatever work you do it as service unto God. See God in everything that comes in your sight. So far, you know, we have labeled, you know, this is spiritual, this is unspiritual. When we attend to the programs in a temple or an ashram, we feel we are involved in spiritual activities. Automatically, we name the other one as non-spiritual. This is our struggle. It doesn't leave any deep impression in us. So a stage comes when you feel disgusted and frustrated with all these activities. Because there is a disconnect. Papa clearly mentions, now Vinobaji clearly mentions. Papa says, you must be able to feel that always. And it is for feeling that Nama chanting has been given to us. But unfortunately, Nama chanting has become an activity. So where do we draw the line? Just now you heard, you know, Papa telling, repetition is for remembrance. To remember him more and more, behind every thought, every word, every deed, we are trying to practice, we are trying to train the mind to dwell on God's name, that's all. So there is no question of chanting, the experience we have during the chanting period and the non-chanting period. It should be the same, no? Having taken up the chanting for decades together now, when we found that we have not been able to hold on to that remembrance during the non-chanting time, we have to evolve a method suitable to ourselves. Now it is very clear what we have been doing under the banner of chanting or bhajan or anything, you know. It is only to keep up the remembrance. And that remembrance should be stretched to everything, right from the moment we wake up till we retire to bed. If this is becoming clearer to us, we know where the ditch is. Vinobaji said, no, so long as there is an inner and outer, we have not started beginning. So we are here, we are here to demolish the barrier between inner and outer. There is no spiritual and mundane. Something on which we have to keep on thinking, you know, keep on going inside, not thinking. God is both manifest and unmanifest. He is formless, yet has different forms. He is and he is not. And he is with and without attributes. He is manifest in all the different forms and types that one can imagine. The whole universe that we witness is suffused with God in various forms. But we fail to recognize in all these forms. The external vision can see the physical form, but fails to see the inner principle that is God. Mataji put it very simply for us, but still we did not understand, you know. We have to find out which is the barrier, which is the one which makes us feel disconnect. Probably instead of breaking our heads through this type, we try to bring in the bhakti bhava, you know. It will be easy. For that, what we need is, you know, unshakable faith that He is there first. So that we can have a dialogue, we can complain to Him, we can... Even that complaining helps us to maintain our remembrance. Each one has to choose. Vinobaji says, realization of the Supreme is of two types. One is through meditation, the other is through devotion and love. How to experience the omnipresence of God is an impenetrable, mysterious question. Unless and until one knows how to transcend the mind, one cannot even get a clue as to how to answer this question. To be able to see God in all the people, trees, animals around us is the real realization of God. We are living beings and full of consciousness. If an ant comes and sits on our leg, it has no awareness that it is touching a living organism. It sits on our leg as if it was just another piece of matter. Our state of awareness is similar. An ant has no cognizance of the touch of a living being and thinks that it is sitting on a clump of clay. Similarly, we are in the embrace of God all the time, but we see a house as a house, a tree as a tree, land as a land. We do not see God there. All the time, we are with Him. We are constantly touched by God or sitting on His lap, yet unfortunately we have no cognizance of it. Ekanath says, one sees the grain of sugar but does not see the sweetness therein. The sweetness will be felt only when one tastes it. Similarly, if one gives up ego, I-ness, then one will see God, who is present in everything and everywhere. Whenever you look, wherever you look, the presence of God will be felt. The intelligence will not be able to analyze it, as it is a matter of intuitive experience only. Now, some proof, you know. If meditation makes one experience that unity, then one must see it in the external world as well. If one sees an ant moving, you know, in insect, one should feel as if God is moving. God is present in human beings, cows, rocks, stones. Acquiring this knowledge of unity is coming to an important beginning stage. But one must go beyond that. One might see God in a particular idol or object of worship, but fail to see God in another human being. That means there is lack of realization. Being able to see God in a particular idol is an outcome of intense faith. Whereas being able to see God in everything and everywhere is an outcome of the realization of Supreme Self.
Do we feel His presence in anything?
Do we
feel His presence in anything, really?
We have
no need to come in other ways, you know. If you are given the name, am I getting feeling of presence of God?
Yeah.
Do I get?
For that, we should. See, that is why. All these things we are struggling because we don't have the right concept of God. This morning, yesterday evening, you were talking. You know, we were thinking about it for a long time. So all Mahatmas, all Shastras keep on telling that He is there in the form of life force. So every now and then we feel that God is separate. I am a seeker trying to see God. I am an aspirant, I am a sadhaka, trying to feel the experience of God. Whenever such thoughts come, I am a devotee. Probably the easiest way could be, just close our eyes, 10 times we count our breathing. Breathing. We don't have to go anywhere to organize anything, na? When we try to observe our own breathing, slowly we realize that it is not articulated by us. Next, we feel the pulse. 1 minute we count. we know there is no absolute concentration will be there, because in 1 minute the mind will not go anywhere, whether it touches 70 or somewhere near 70. Then stop. Are we articulating this pulse? Suppose we say to pulse, stop beating now. It will not hear. When we say to the breathing, stop breathing now. Okay, you may be able to hold on for a few seconds. These two, you know, easy for us to organize. Nobody will know also. So when we know that there is a power that is controlling the breathing or the, what do you call it, pulse beat. Oh, then immediately we remember our guru said life is the expression of Atman. Though seemingly two, they are one. So life is normally, you know, identified when somebody passes away, when the doctor comes, what does he do? Have you observed? He will first feel the pulse, he will open the eyes, he will put the torch, whether there is any sensitivity. He will scratch on your foot, whether it is moving. So there are some symbols or some devices by which the life force is there or not, we identify. So these are all life forces, we know that. And life is the expression of Atman. First stage, it is not the breathing alone is Atman. Life is the expression of Atman. So that means he is inside now. And because the breathing is going on, the mind is working. Intelligence is working. Identification is going on. The mind creates a world. So we start slowly realizing the presence of that life force, the heart. Again we forget when we open, we talk. So every now and then, suppose we resort to some method like this, you know. If the witness consciousness cannot be practiced, if whatever Papa says should be the attitude while chanting Ramnam, if there cannot be practiced, we can try this also. Look, because we have to have some clarity on the word God. Then all these things, you know, whatever Papa says, we can understand now. He is with us, within us. All prayers, we can understand. So breathing or the pulse beat, which we know that not articulated by us, not originated by us, not intended by us, not done by us, which is the base for the entire activity of an individual, that is the expression of Atman. So we slowly try, you know. So Atman is with me always. Now we can understand Papa's words. When you are chanting Ram Nam, you are chanting the name of your own self, Atma Ram. You do not know that you are Atma Ram. So ceaselessly you remember to awaken yourself that you are Ram. These are all in words. It is for that purpose he has asked us to chant. You are chanting the name of your own self, you say. We still fail, agree. But suppose we develop this, whenever we are in past moment, we are in sattvic moment, we can try it. And when we keep on trying, we will see other person also is having the same thing. And at the level of this breathing, we will experience by ourselves that there are no other thoughts. Just like when we start counting the pulse beat, the unknowingly the thought is not going out at all. Because then the count goes. If the mind goes out, the count goes, you know. So nobody need teacher. Suppose you look at the watch and you start counting, you will not bother about anything. Tuck, 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 no? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like that, up to 70, the mind gets totally controlled. Similarly, 10 times breathing. If our mind goes out, what will happen? Counting gets broken. So we know a technique. We are not aware that there is a technique. We are implementing the technique. At the same time, we are not aware that it is a technique that is from us. When we do the cycling, we get the balance. When we do the swimming, we get the balance. When we learn the alphabets and the conjugation of verbs, automatically we learn how to form a proper word, sentence. At that time, we are not aware of anything else. Automatic, you know, automatic. I take, I am taking, I have taken, I have been taking, you know. We will not make any mistake in it. I taken, we will never say that. Where can it come? When am or is, put ing is there in the active voice. In the passive voice, the past participle is there. Okay, all these things are automatic, you know. We don't commit any mistake. So the entire faculty, because he is there at the faculty, to remember and to apply. But we are driving, you know, how much time you took while learning the driving. And after when once you became an expert driver, you are not even aware that you are driving. Meticulous. Automatic, you know, where your hands should go, where your right leg should go, or left leg should go. Your eyes, your ears, your view on the rear mirror, your hearing the horn, your seeing the signal. The technique gets evolved, you know, and gets embedded even you are not aware of it. So now we slowly start feeling all these capabilities are there, faculties are there, capabilities are there. So, with that capability which is already there, we will also try to understand the presence of the life force. We take it as granted now. Early morning when we get up, we go to the bathroom, brush the teeth, go to the toilet, go to the bathroom and then change and then do this. Automatic. You are not aware that there is an orderliness, there is a method, there is a perfection in everything. So now, when we are struggling, we know that it is all because the life force is there. All these things I am in a position to do right from the morning because the life force is there. And life force, the expression, Atman is, life is the expression of Atman. Papa adds one more word. Though seemingly two, they are one. It could be one method. The name is God, Papa used to say, you know. We have to, any object we see. Mataji elaborately discusses that, no? In simple language, Mataji says, the devotee even gets to know what that ultimate state of realization would be, like the vast space around us and between us, and so on. Just to bring some thought into your mind, as soon as that thought ends, There is a pause before you think of another thought, and the mind is blank in this period. That blankness is God. The vacant space between you and me is God. So much is He is all pervading. Such an all pervading God is seated in your heart. As I went on doing what Papa had told me, I began to identify every article I saw, be it a flower, a piece of cloth, or any other article, with its source, namely God. And tell myself, what a beautiful thing Papa has wrought. Gradually, Papa's thought, you know, God's thought filled me through and through. The void that pervaded all around me permeated my mind also. There would then be ensue long spells of void or utter blankness of mind between two thoughts. The Nirguna Nirakara Papa has manifested as the entire universe with innumerable names and forms. He is seated in your heart and in everybody's heart. This is another method of space. This is another method. When we started probing deep into it, we find that the breathing we have now understood, the breathing comes from outside. The articulation, because we have heard, or even in our case we have experienced, we have observed, not experienced, sorry, observed, that when one is in a room, tight room, where there is no, what do you call it, ventilation, and there is only one smoke, you know, carbon monoxide. Yesterday morning he died. Suddenly we start thinking. So the breathing is possible because it is coming from outside. Through the doorway of our nostrils and mouth. So the life force expressed through the breathing is outside. It is entering into us and becomes inside. That is why when Vinobaji said, so long as we have got this differentiation between inside and outside as separate, we have not started the journey. Because every time the clash will come. But here now slowly, you know, it is now becoming clearer to us that the outside air, prana, is entering into us and making this equipment feel vibrant and living. So there is no out, the inner, indwelling reality and the all pervading reality is one and the same. This is what Papa said, even before he started the itinerant journey, he was chanting the God's name ceaselessly, coupled with the attributes like the indwelling and all pervading aspect of God. So this clarity had come to him right from the beginning. Somewhere you have to make a beginning. No? That means lots of probing deep into it, not at the surface level. And at the depth level when we go, we suddenly find whether then only we can say that whether we regard him or not, whether we remember him or not, whether we deny him or not, whether we ignore him or not, whether we insult him or not. He is not leaving us. He continues to give us the life force. No? So why chanting Ramnam? In between chanting Ramnam, when hearing Ramnam, if we can bring all these dimensions, I won't say all these, any of these dimensions, then our Ramnam becomes effective. As Gandhiji said, one Ramnam should push us towards it. Another Ramnam should push us towards it. Third Ramnam should push us. Now I am not feeling that push. I am chanting. I don't feel I am moving towards him. because I have not brought him before me. Suppose I am praying, you are making me to chant that naam, and you are giving me a feeling that I am not moving towards you. This is first class. You have already remembered him. But praying to him to give us the feeling that we are moving towards him, that's all. We are in him, but we feel we are away from him, and so we have to move towards him, and so we are praying now. You are making me to chant, but still I don't feel the nearness. You say chanting is for remembrance. Remembrance means nearness. Remembrance means presence. Remembrance means darshan. Remembrance means the surrender. Everything has been coined in that, no? Why are you not doing it? This method, any of these methods we keep on employing and see for ourselves. In spite of the fact that we are in him, we feel we are away from him. So then, whenever we feel frustrated, we go to the masters and Papa, in our case Papa, Papa says the abstract is that the sense of individuality is dominating. So try, that is called purification. So try some method. When you identify, you employ some other. One method is, without you I cannot do anything. The moment the breathing stops, finished. So depth of a person enables us to know the presence of life force in us. Just like, you know, we don't recognize the breathing now, though breathing goes on. Just like that, we don't even recognize the life force in us. In our hurry to live the life, we have our own sankalpas and vikalpas, vikshepas. We try to do so many things. In that process, we don't feel there is a life force in us. With the life force only, we are able to do that. So, just as somebody reminds us, oh, because the body is inert, insentient. Body is not reacting, it was reacting. It was responding. So in this body, that life force is there now, which is not articulated by me, which is not propelled by me, which is not originated by me, which is not controlled by me. What is Sakshatkar? He says, realization of the Atman. Knowing that you are the Atman and not the body, that is Atma Sakshatkar. God experience. Sarvadi Sakshi Bhutam. The witness consciousness which is at the back of the intellect is the Atman, the Sadguru, the Satchidananda. And that Atman is yourself. To be conscious of it, to realize it, to experience it, to attain the state of witness consciousness is Atma Sakshatkar. Devotee, I repeat Ramna, but there is no progress. Papa, if you really want it, you will get it. Where there is demand, there is supply. Ramdas will tell you how. Ramdas himself hungered for the truth, went to saints, got it. If he had no hunger, he would not have got it. They cannot do anything for you if you are not receptive. You must feel the want. You must have a burning thirst for it. The condition is hunger for God. You have seen so many saints. How is it that nobody was able to do anything for you? Devotee, a saint can do what he likes. You must give me that thirst. Again, no, the Papa. Ramdas is trying his best to see that everybody is awakened. But nobody responds. Otherwise, he would have transformed the whole world in a second. do constant repetition of Ramana with full faith in Ramdas's words, then you will get everything in course of time. Devotee, Papa should give it. He has the power to give. Papa, Ramdas is giving, but nobody is prepared to take. You are full of kama, krodha, lobha, etc. There is no place inside. You must leave the ego and surrender to the Guru. The more you repeat Ramnam with faith and devotion, the more you will become ready to receive the grace of the Guru. You must do the sadhana and utterly surrender to God. At once you will realize God. Wow. Try for yourself. By taking the name constantly with full faith, everything is in Ramnam. Devotee, we are thirst for God, but don't get time to repeat Ramnam. Baba, where is the thirst? If you do not take the name, every minute available you will utilize for Ramana. How much time you waste in useless talk? Devotee, domestic worries prevent us from taking the name. No concentration is possible. Baba, concentration or no concentration, repeat. Your thirst for worldly things is more. If you have real thirst for God, you will repeat the name and all worries will disappear. Devotee, but when worries are there, how to repeat Ramana? Papa, if there is no worry, what is the necessity of Ramana? It is because of worry that you want Ramana to save you from the worry. Then Papa finally would have thought, you know, this is going on for some time. By discussing, you cannot get anything. Intellect leads you away from God. It is through the heart you get God. Accept the same words, accept to them, give all your love to God, call Him in utter surrender, that instant you will have. Devotee, we repeat Ramnam in the hope of getting liberation. Supposing we do not realize God before death, what would be the use of the repetition then? Do not speculate upon the future, Papa. The present should be used for repetition of Ramnam. Instead, you try to remember the past and worry about the future. Past is past, future is in the hands of God. You dwell in worries, fears and expectation of the future. The present joy you lose. Darshan, liberation, samadhi, everything is included in Ramnam. With that faith, repeat Ramnam from moment to moment. Ramdas never thought of the past or the future. He enjoyed the bliss of the name. He did not want Ram Darshan. Name itself was giving him peace and bliss. Kindly advise how to repeat Ramana. Papa, you want to free your mind from worries and cares which harass you? Ramana is the way. Practice that and see. Do not think of the past or the future. Every moment is slipping by without you are doing the right thing to free yourself from the entanglements in which you are caught. Do not bother about anything else. Take Ramnam as much as you can. You must have peace. That is what you are after. You must think how best you can take the Ramnam. How to be always in the thought of God. Slowly He will bring. That this should be your concern. God is absolute peace and bliss. When you forget Him, you feel restless and worried. Repeat the name and see how you are free from all troubles and anxieties. Your mind will be bathing in peace. Whatever anybody says or whatever you find in books, lay them aside. Many people think that by reading books they would get everything. Repeat Ramnam, practice remembrance of God. With full faith and devotion, go forward. You will meet God. If you want to see God, you must have a pure heart. Purity is attained by remembering Him. That is the only way to purify the mind. If you call mother, she comes to you. If you want her to come to you soon, you must continuously call her. If you stop calling, the mother thinks you don't want her. If you insistently call her, she will surely come. If you want to get darshan of the Universal Mother, your prayer must be unceasing. Then she is sure to reveal. When we started Ramnam in a low pitch, we were told it is in a low pitch. Then we tried to raise it. at that time, that particular bhajan, you know, came to our mind, which we shared with you. We don't know the full lyrics. Yakantavasa, Enneyal, Misha, Enkural, Yattavillayo. So every time when we chant, we should know whether have you heard? Enkural, Yattavillayo means, have you not heard my sound? A devotee prayed to Lord Ayyappa. Yakantavasa, Enneyal, Misha, you are my indwelling inner ruler. Yen kural attavillayo. So while we chant, you know, suppose we have that. Have you not heard? I am calling you. Are you deaf? Why are you changing your face to that side? Change to this side. I am calling you, you know. I am drawing your attention. Like that feeling, you know. Bubiyalum perumale ponnangala periyone. பதினெட்டாம் படியில் வாழும் பத்மாசனம் கொண்டோனே ஏகாந்த வாசா என்னையாள் மீஷா என் குரல் எட்டவில்லையோ. தேர் இஸ் ஏஸ் யூ நோ நாட் ஓன்லி இன்வெல்லிங் ஆல் பர்வேடிங் புவியாளும் பெருமானே யூ ஆர் த லார்ட் ஆஃப் த யூனிவர்ஸ் பொன்னம்பல பெரியோனே யூ ஆர் த டேட்டி ஆஃப் திஸ் டெம்பிள் ஆல்சோ. பதினெட்டாம் படியில் வாழும் தெர் ஆர் 18 ஸ்டெப்ஸ் யூ நோ வி கிவ் கோ த்ரூ தி வேதாந்திக் லைன். Why 18? No? 18 is what I mean. Because there are 18 steps here. Inside he is. So, Padinatam Padimel Varun Patmasanam Kondone. Did you hear my calling? So, in other words, when we chant Ramnam, we say it is low pitch, agreed. At the ashram level, yes. It should become on the higher pitch. But not merely at the outer level. It should be in the inner level. Easy hearing, that means whether I am getting concentrated in my calling. Are you hearing? Then when we keep on doing like that, intuitionally the answer will come. Who is making you to chant? Then why should you doubt that I am not hearing? So some sloga, some bhajan will definitely help us. Some sloga, some bhajan, you know, simple bhajan. Especially Bhaktivedanta, when they have composed, it is very, very touching. So we try to remember all these and make use of all these for a feeling is present inside and then outside. First we have to realize him inside. So many bhajans are now welling up in our mind. Ullam urugudaiya. Vinnadi kangayire. Alli anaippa or aval thirugudaiya. There are in Malayalam and Tamil, number of, you know, Bhaktivedantas. They couldn't contain themselves. So when we now combine Papa's Ramnam chanting with those, my chanting should become calling. Call on the Lord. There is a beautiful article by Papa. Call on the Lord. There he says, our calling should be such that he has to open. So our Ramnam chanting should be now, it should not be chanting. Thereafter I don't think we should say it's a chanting. Knocking the door, no? Outwardly we may use the word chanting, but inside we should know we are knocking the door.
Swamiji.
Yes?
How do we know he has heard?
Intuitionally we will hear. At the exclusion of all other thoughts, when devotion wells up in our heart, suddenly intuitionally you will feel he is hearing, he will talk to you. Who is giving you the power to call me now? Oh, sorry. like that, you know, the dialogue is. But exclusive. He said hunger for that. Hunger should be there. Thirst should be there. So we will make the God as facilitated before us. Wonderful bhajans, you know, wonderful bhajans.
Can we do it systematically?
Why not? One bhajan every day, you know, before you chant Ramna. So create a mental atmosphere. And then you chant. That means you are knocking the door. Day after tomorrow I will read out the call on the Lord. Call on the Lord. That's the same word he has used. The article name, the title of the article is call on the Lord. Because we have been chanting Ramna. We must get the result. There is no question of postponing. Luckily he has drawn us. Luckily he has given us a taste. Luckily we enjoy it to a very great extent, but still we feel we are away from Him. That should not be. We must be
like water dropping on the rock.
Eh?
Water dropping on the rock.
Ah, yeah, yeah. It will slowly, it will have its dent. Water slowly dropping on the rock, continuously, perseveringly, when we do that, it will even the rock will melt. So try to now locate some bhajan, you know, some bhajan that touches your heart. It bridges, it creates a proper ambience in our heart. We are doing bhajan now just for the sake of enjoying the tune, the music, to be very frank. We hardly travel with the theme. Because when we travel with the theme, it will be reflected in our feelings. When we repeat prayer, the same Prabhu Vishwanatha can give us a different meaning. The same arati, the same concluding session in the morning, an arati session. Everything will have a different meaning to us. Because Mataji knew that it cannot be dry. Simply you go and say, God is within, God is without. Do the sadhana. No. She did not do that. So many programs she has inserted so that it doesn't become dry. At the same time, everything will give a push. Whatever we have discussed, you know, now Papa says, Vinobaji says, this is what is now captured in the last word of our arati program. Jya jya sarihe manajaya maje. Jya jya sarihe nijarupa tuje. That is the sum and substance of today's my sadhana, no? But we have not applied our mind. As a routine, we just repeat, that's all. So now everything, you know, our bhajan will have a new meaning, our arati will have a new meaning, our Prabhu Vishwanatha will have a new meaning, prayer will have a new meaning. When we say adorable presence, previously we were repeating the name, the word. When the presence, oh, the presence because of which you are what you are, the living presence, that is what is meant. Because A and P are capital. Adorable presence, you know, revered. Adore means an adorable means revered, respected. Presence means sanityam. The life force, your sanityam. So every prayer is seen with a different perspective now. As we all enjoy bhajan, we can have wonderful, beautiful bhajan every day before we start Ramna at home. I am not talking about ashram. Ashram also, Mataji said, you know, preceding Ramna session, there is a bhajan session. But none of us make use of it in that. Even we fight, you know, my imagine, I have not been given time, that's all. The purpose of bhajan is to create a proper ambience in our mind, so that the nama can take us, quell all our thoughts. And it slowly push us from outward to inward, or inward to outward. Towards it, towards the holy person. So let us all try to absorb all these thoughts and then pray to him from the bottom of the heart. You are within us. Intellectually we have 100% agreement with it. You have given us the holy and all powerful Ramnam to get us awakened to this reality. Today also you chose to remind us that chanting is for remembrance. Now, bless us, pour your grace on us so that we try to take everything, whatever you have facilitated, we have been using it, but we have not been really using it. We have been doing bhajan, but we have not been trying to understand the presence of it. We have been doing Ramnam, we have not been trying to understand the remembrance. We have been attending satsang, we have not been trying. Everything becomes outward activity, diversion. Yeah. Everything becomes a diversion. Just like an entertainment, it's a diversion. That's right. It doesn't leave a deep impression. Immediately after this satsang, for example, suppose you go back, without applying, without trying to assimilate, noting down, going through the book, you just go through that. The effect will be different. But the moment you plunge yourself in your ordinary activities immediately after the satsang, it will get diluted. The interest or the earnestness that is shown during the satsang period, it gets slowly evaporated. As you know, we bring in so many preoccupations one after another. That is why when we were in school, when the teacher takes classes, he will also give us homework. So that what is learned, we try to go something of it and tomorrow we prepare. Every now and then they give us from composition book. You remember? It will be given to the teacher for going through. Then periodical test, monthly test, then quarterly exam, half yearly exam, and final exam. Kindly remember the word Mataji is there, ashram is a school. So when, what is happening is, when we do Ramnam before and after, we don't apply our mind, unknowingly. When we do bhajan, we don't apply our mind before and after it. When we attend satsang, we don't apply our mind before and after it. So that means it doesn't leave any indelible impression, deep impression. That is why at the time of chanting, at the time of hearing bhajan, at the time of satsang, everything is thrilling. The moment after that, we are back to square one. That is why we said it is a diversion now. No doubt, it's a positive diversion. It is not something negative, but it's a positive diversion. It should not be diversion. It should be a learning. It should be a move towards the core of our being. Let us all try to assimilate as much as we can, whatever Papa has shared with us. One thing is definite. He is with us. So, we don't have to worry to bring him into the picture. He is already with us. That tension is not there now. It is not that we have to somehow bring him, catch hold of him, hiding somewhere. He is with us. Now when here he is with us. Now we are only praying to him. Make us aware of him. हरि ओम श्री राम जय राम। जय जय राम ओ श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओ जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओ
राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम जय राम जय जय राम